Good morning, everybody. Welcome to EMnation Coffee Talk. I'm Larry Wallace, and this is my wife, Staci Wallace, and together we're the founders of EMnation. EMnation stands for Empowering Nations with the Truth of God's Word. We're so glad that you guys are joining us this morning, and I've got my YouTube talking to me.
Attention, RVers. Good morning, everyone. We have a great week planned for you this week. First off, we've been taking time away, just really relaxing, coming off of social media, not doing any posting, and really just listening, praying, spending time with family, and having some nice time away. This week, though, we've got a great week planned for you because we're going to be talking about four life lessons that sports taught us. And most of you know that Larry played football for Texas A&M and was an amazing player. And
you may not know this, but Staci was an amazing basketball player. In fact, she was picked to be on the Junior Olympic team
and scored
like 3 points like nobody's business.
Yeah, so we played at a high level of sports, and it was really interesting this weekend. Both of us went from our sport. My sport was basketball, so I played very, very competitive basketball. Larry played football. Texas A&M won a lot of championships. We came out of sports and went into another sport. I went into martial arts, became a black belt in karate, mixed martial arts, kickboxing, and Larry went into bodybuilding. And so there's some things that sports teach you that people who don't play sports may never get the value, but we want to talk about four life lessons. And the reason why we're talking about this weekend is I had the privilege. Now, we have two kids that aren't necessarily into sports. They're very, very talented, just not in sports. But this weekend, you were with our nephew. And you were sitting down at the kitchen table, and he's going into football for the first time this year. I believe he's a freshman.
Yes, yeah.
And so he is actually an incredible athlete, really, really good at baseball, but he wants to take his hand at football. And so Larry sat down, and I was hearing stories that I have never heard before. And I sat back, and I was like, wow, you have got so much wisdom in the area of mindset training when it comes to sports that can just parlay over to every single area of life.
Yeah, it's funny because Staci said, you're telling stories I've never heard before. And I was like, well, nobody's wanting to hear them. This is the first time. And so we're happy.
I want to hear your stories.
Oh, thank you. Well, you know, because all the other nephews, this is the first nephew that we've had that's gone into...
Or child,
yeah, first relative, let's put it that way, whether it's a direct descendant of us or someone else in the family that has wanted to pursue football. And so it happens to be my sport.
Your sweet spot.
My sweet spot. And so we spent some time talking this weekend, and it was great.
And so today, every day, we're going to be talking about a life lesson that you can apply to your mindset so that you can become more effective at whatever it is that you do. This is going to be great for moms. This is going to be great for teachers, doctors, lawyers, athletes. But these four life lessons, I was taking notes, and I was like, oh my goodness, what you're teaching them is pure gold right now. Now, the first one is how to play big. You're playing small will not change the world.
Yeah, and I have to give a shout out because Denise said, and you're great at playing tennis too.
Yeah,
she's amazing at playing tennis, and she's
amazing. Well, I just have the sports
at playing golf.
Chip.
So she actually can play just about any sports that she can.
I don't like football. I don't like to be tackled unless it's you, of course.
So Staci has a very athletic gift to be able to pick up any sport and play it well. So she does really good. So to Denise's point, she's a great tennis player too.
So when you were talking to Brennan yesterday, you were talking about how to play, you know, you said you're playing small, buddy, will not change the world.
Yeah.
How did you describe that to him?
Yeah, you know, I told him, I said, whenever you're out on the field, you have to play like you're 10 feet tall and bulletproof. Because if you go with a mindset that I'm smaller, I'm the least among them, or whatever, you're not gonna have the right mental attitude that you need in order to play the game at a top level.
So even if you're, like for me, when I played basketball, I'm only 5'7", mm-hmm. and it seems like that's getting shorter. So now I'm like 5'6¼". I'm getting taller.
But honey, we're getting shorter together.
Yes.
So you still look like you're the same height.
Yeah, so 5'7" is short for basketball, but I happen to be a point guard, and I was really good at ball handling and outside shots. And I played with a resilience that I didn't have the fear chip.
Right.
So I really thought I was the biggest girl on the court, and I would play, even when we played guy,
Yeah, I was going to say, because even we played 3-on-3 and then
years.
Tournament games where we played 5-on-5, we would put together a team, and we played all well into our mid to late 30s.
And I'd be the only girl on the whole league.
And so Staci would do, she would shoot 3 points from the outside, and if they started double teaming her on the outside, she would either feed the ball in, or she would, if she was, if someone had made the mistake, well, actually, if someone made the mistake and did a one-on-one, she would do a pump fake and then drive the lane. Not too many girls on a guy's team or all guys.
At that time. Now it's a little different because you got.
Would do a pump fake and drive the lane, but she would. And it was all, it always blow people, it would keep them off guard.
Well, I didn't have the fear chip. I didn't have the chip that you're bigger than me, so I should be afraid of you. I had the chip that you're taking my domain. You're in my way of getting to the goal that I want to accomplish. And that really is a very important life lesson when it comes to getting what you want or what God has ordained for you to have in your life, is you've got to play like you're 10 feet tall and bulletproof. You've got to know what has he given you authority to have. Like, what is supposed to be your measure of rule, whether it's in business, whether it's your children, your family, your health, and then go after it like you are bigger, badder, stronger, smarter, wiser, that you're going to outlive, outlast, outsurvive, whatever that is, whether it's a disease, whether it's somebody's coming against you. You've got to be 10 foot tall and bulletproof.
You know, everybody has those voices inside their head. And I've seen many of athlete through my career where I would see a guy who's 6'7 and weighs 300 pounds. And he plays like he's 5'2 and 150, right? And the reason is the mental attitude, because these guys, you know, someone may have said something negative to him, may have torn him down, may have said something to him that that hurt his feelings or made him feel like he was not worthy. And he would get out onto the field and not perform as if he was larger than life. I mean, a Goliath of a man would play like he was a midget. And
yeah.
And so here's the thing, is like you have to shut out those voices. You have to turn down the voice of the enemy in your life and say, no, I'm a child of God. I'm 10 feet tall and bulletproof. And
yeah.
It's amazing that mindset, how it will change your performance. And that's whether you're on the field mm-hmm. or in life, you know, whether you're at your job or whatever it may be. If you have that mindset, it's amazing how it can change your outlook on life and change your performance.
And a lot of times you may be trying something new that you've never tried before. And so there's that trepidation or that fear that, what if I fail? So what? People fail every day. The greatest inventions of the world, the greatest businesses in the world are not there because they nailed it the first time. It's because they failed forward. So when you are 10 foot tall and bulletproof, it doesn't mean that you're the strongest. Doesn't mean you're the smartest. Doesn't mean that you have the biggest pedigree. What it means is you are resilient, unstoppable, irrevocably, you're going to get what it is that's set in front of you. Interestingly enough, this is Shark Week. Started Sunday night. Now, Shark Week, like right now, I think there's like 72 million people are going to be watching. No, 72 countries and something like 35 million people are going to be watching. It's a really big deal on Discovery Channel. And people just sit back and they watch all these discoveries about sharks. They watch shark attacks and Shark Week, right? So it's a pretty big deal. But what most people don't realize is that although sharks are the big bad dogs of the ocean, when it comes to dolphins, now a shark can take out a dolphin. They eat dolphins all the time, right? But if a shark goes after a pod or a dolphin's baby, and that's usually what they do, is they try to go after prey that's smaller than them. I learned all this because you're going to watch Shark Week, right? What happens is when they go after a baby, what they try to do is they try to separate it from the pack. We're going to talk about this week on how important it is to play with your pack and to be a team leader. That's going to be on another day. But what they do is they try to separate the little dolphin, the baby dolphin, from the pack so that they can eat it. The minute a mama finds this out, she goes hog wild. And so she may not be as strong or have the teeth like a shark does. She has agility, speed, and she has an ability to go vertical and drop vertical, and a shark does not. So she uses what she's got in order to go very, very fast around the shark and just bump it. And there's a soft underside belly of the shark that she bumps, and basically it stuns, kind of like knocks the breath out of him. But the whole point is, you're not gonna take what's mine.
Right.
And that's the mentality. I heard you talking yesterday with Brennan. Is Brennan, man, it's, you were so excited because he's right now, he's so pumped up and it's just getting started. And you were like, you've gotta have that mentality that you are the biggest guy on the field. And don't play with fear. Play big. Because playing small will not change your team. It won't change people's lives. Last night, we saw that even with EMwomen on our online connect group. Last night, we're talking about 10 steps to becoming a more effective public speaker.
Yeah.
And so we had each woman take their turn. We taught them how to write a two-minute story. And then we had them share with the group. And some women were more excited than others. Others had glossophobia, which is the fear of public speaking. And one particular lady, which by the time we were done, she nailed it. But when she got started, she started off apologizing and saying, she was really good at talking about her grandbabies.
Right, because like, that was something that she was really comfortable about talking. But as soon as it switched over to her business, then she started saying, was just struggling with finding the words to say.
And I said, what just happened is you're 10 foot tall and bulletproof when you talk about your grandbabies, because you know them and you know you're the number one grandma in the world. But when it came to talking about your new business, all of a sudden your cadence changed, your tone changed, your body language changed. You started saying, because you don't feel 10 foot tall and bulletproof when you're presenting your business. And for those of you who own your own business right now, this is a really important lesson. Just like horses can smell fear, so can customers. They know when somebody's shady or when they don't really believe in their business. Kids know when their parents aren't really telling the truth, or you're telling them something that you're not willing to do yourself, like clean up your room and your room's a mess. Or you guys need to be on time, yet you show up late to church every single Sunday.
Or maybe you're negotiating for something like a car, or maybe you're negotiating a business deal, and all of a sudden you start showing that you're nervous. The other person's gonna pick up on that. They're gonna say, I gotcha.
And we're not talking about ego in a way that a negative ego. We're talking about a certainty that outweighs all uncertainty. It requires a bit of that type of ego, which isn't necessarily, I mean, obviously God had to have some type of ego in order to create the universe. Jesus had to have some pretty good severe confidence in order to walk through the crowd and to do what he did. This is what we're talking about. It's a balanced approach to knowing who you are, whose you are, and the fact that he's giving you all dominion on earth. Now, one of the things that is real important when we talk about this is the story of David.
Right.
David was 10 foot tall and bulletproof.
Yeah. 1 Samuel 17. I'm telling you. Now, talk about someone who had the mindset to go in and, you know, basically confront Goliath. And but here's the thing, is like over time he had built up that confidence because he had had an encounter with a bear, he had an encounter with a lion, I'm sure he had an encounter with wolves along the path, and it built up his confidence. But when he walked in, everybody else at that particular event where Goliath was, they had this mindset of, we are smaller than Goliath, we're smaller than this giant, and everybody had this mentality that there's no way I could defeat
him. Every time Goliath would come out of his tent, now remember Goliath was huge, he was the Philistine, he would come out of his tent and he would badmouth the Israelites' God, the Israelite
every morning,
army,
every evening.
Yeah, they would run in fear and hide in their tents.
Yep.
So here little David, 10 foot tall and bulletproof, walks up carrying the, you know, you see him carrying his little McDonald's bag to his brothers.
Yep.
And he goes to his brothers and he's saying, hey, how's it going? And they're like, it's going great, but there's this Philistine guy. And then all of a sudden, boom, boom, here comes Goliath. And he does this thing and David's brothers run in the tent, all these.
They're all shaking in their boots. And David's like, what are you guys doing?
He's like, why is everybody doing this? And so they tell him, this guy is unstoppable. He's like, he's so big. It's almost like Joshua and Caleb. You know, we're like grasshoppers in his sight. And David goes, now this is an important a very important key when it comes to being 10 foot tall and bulletproof. Know your battles and count the cost.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you recognize, wait a minute, God's already given me dominion here. He's already assured me of victory. The only thing that stands between me and the plunder is my faith. So God's already given you a promise that you would be the head and not the tail, above only, not beneath, blessed coming in, blessed going out. He's already promised that he's fought the battle for you. So the only thing that's standing between you and success, if your success is truly motivated to want to do good, to advance the kingdom of God, to be Jesus' hands and feet on the planet, then you've already been assured the victory. The only thing standing between you and that victory is your faith. Mm-hmm. So what happens with little David when he says, so what's in it for the guy who wins?
Yeah, so they tell him, like, look, you not only get the daughter of the king in marriage, but you and your whole family don't have to pay taxes ever again.
And there's a plunder of wealth that comes with being
a part of the
kingdom.
King's family, yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. So David is like, are you guys kidding me? Like, that's even worth dying over.
Right. And they're saying, but he's so big. And he's like, he's so big, I can't miss.
So he goes to King Saul and says, I got this guy. Like, and Saul goes, yeah, buddy, listen, look, this guy's big. The reason why we're all scared is because the guy's massive and he has his armor. And David goes, yeah, but you don't understand. I killed the lion. Mm-hmm. I killed the bear. And my God is for me. And if my God's for me, who can be against me? If he's on my side, whom shall I fear? Mm-hmm. And so Saul looks at him and goes, all right, kid, strap on some armor. So,
well, he tried to give him Saul's armor and it was too big for him. And that's a whole nother story. That's a whole nother sermon.
Trying
right
to
there.
Be something you're not.
Right. Or trying to wear somebody else's clothes.
Or trying to fit into somebody else's shoe, Cinderella, that doesn't fit you. Mm-hmm. God has a plan and a purpose that only you can walk in.
So he tried it on and he says, no, I can't wear this. I have to be myself. And that was a really important thing for him to say. So he was said, I'm going to be myself. And so he took what he knew, and that was the 5 smooth stones and his sling. And he went out there and faced him.
Y'all should read that story, 1 Samuel 17. Just read the whole chapter there and on through there. Read the story of how a young boy is 10 foot tall and bulletproof. And then look at your life and say, what is it that you've been praying to God for, asking God for, hoping, wishing, dreaming about? And ask yourself, am I 10 foot tall and bulletproof like little David? Or am I more like an Israelite who keeps hiding in the tent going, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? What am I going to do? Because the only thing standing between you and victory is your faith.
That's right.
God's already given you the promise. Now you've got to stand and believe. Take a few little stones. And those stones might be 5 scriptures. You know, David picked up 5 little stones and all it took was one. But maybe those 5 stones, here's something practical for you to do today. Maybe those 5 stones are 5 scriptures that help elevate your faith today. Maybe it's, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Maybe it's, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Maybe it's, fear not, for I'm with you. Be not dismayed, for I'm your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Find 5 scriptures that every time you walk by the mirror, you can look and you can quote a scripture. That's the breath of God being spoken over you. And those 5 smooth stones can take down any Goliath.
That's right. That's a good message. So you can take that message and apply it to any area of your life. That's a good one.
This week, we're going to talk about 4 life lessons that we've learned in sports. And that was a big one.
Yep.
When it comes to winning. Winning in life, winning in business, winning in family, faith, family, finance, fitness, and freedom. So be back with us tomorrow. We're going to talk about another life lesson. We hope this has blessed you. Let's pray out. And then please, if you're watching today, give us a like, hit the like button. Make sure you've subscribed. Click the notifications bell. What that's going to do is it's going to notify you when we go live and we have these short little motivational hits in the arm for you. And also it helps us because it helps increase the amount of people that see our videos. So we want to be real transparent with that your likes and your comments actually help us reach more people.
Yeah, we come to you guys all the time bringing these videos and bringing these messages to you. And all we ask in return is just to hit that like button, because believe it or not, it does do a lot for us, because it does let YouTube's algorithms, YouTube know that you like what you see and they're gonna make it available to other people. So appreciate you guys hitting that like button. So let's pray. Father, we just thank you, God, for this day. We're so grateful, Father God, for the word that you deliver through us or to us through the Bible. And God, I thank you, Father, that the story of David is an amazing story. Mm-hmm. And I thank you, Father, that we can apply that life lesson no matter what area of life that we're facing challenges in right now. So God, I pray that this penetrates the hearts of the people who watch this video. God, that they play big today, that they play big like they're 10 foot tall and bulletproof, whether they're in negotiations to buy something, whether they're in negotiations with their spouse, whether they're in negotiations with their children or whatever it may be, God. I thank you, Father God, that this message penetrates the hearts of everyone who's watching it. God, that they walk in confidence today and that they know that you are with them, God, and that they are overcomers, that they are champions through Christ Jesus. And we thank you, Father, for these things. In your name we pray, amen.
Amen. Have a great day, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow morning. Again, please subscribe. Go over to Facebook. We'd love to connect with you there as well, or just comment in the comment box, and we always respond back. We love connecting with you. I know there's a live chat that goes on during the video, but after the video, go to the comment box, and that's the best way to connect with us directly. We love talking to you.
Have a great day, everybody. Bye-bye.